Hello, Sirdar here for Dev with Sirdar. And today I'm going to be talking about an alternative implementation of the Python language called Codon, what it does, what it's best at, and whether or not it's a hint for Python's future direction in general. So first, what is Codon exactly? Well, it's a language very similar to Python, although not drop-in compatible, that compiles to native machine code. It follows Python's syntax closely so that many, although again, not all, Python programs will work as Codon programs. The big difference under the hood is that Codon compiles to native machine assembly by way of the LLVM compiler framework, where regular Python runs as bytecode. This is the same technology that powers the Clang and Rust compilers, and it also powers the Numba just-in-time compiler technology that can now be used to speed up Python too. And like Numba, you don't have to compile your whole code base into assembly. You can write regular Python, you can run that with the stock Python runtime, and decorate specific functions to compile as assembly using Codon. You can even do it the other way around. You can write Codon programs with sections that drop back to the Python runtime using a special decorator. So what is the big advantage to doing all this? Speed, mainly speed for math. Python isn't very fast at that kind of work, which is why scientific computing and mathematics is done with libraries like NumPy. Codon, by contrast, wants to let you do such things natively, directly in the language without calling out to external libraries. So to give you an idea of what kinds of speedups we're talking about here, let's take a look at an example program. I have here a simple program that finds prime numbers. It's not a very efficient algorithm. It's just enough of one for our demo. By the way, this is a slight variant on some code that Codon itself has used in one of its demos. So first, we're going to run this program in regular Python, and I'm going to use Python 3.11, since that gives us a few speed advantages over previous versions of Python. And there's nothing in this program that would stop us from doing that. It's a pure Python program. So as you can see, the total time for checking whether or not this number is prime is around 0.04 seconds. Now let's switch to the Codon version. Now, by the way, you'll notice that I'm running Codon in the Windows subsystem for Linux. There is currently no native Windows build of Codon yet. It's just only available for Linux and Mac. So you'll notice that when we run this program in Codon, there is a significant pause when it first runs. And we didn't have that with the plain Python version. That's because of the time taken by the JIT compiler to create the machine language version of the program. With Numba, which also has a JIT, the compiled binaries can be cached so that future runs of the same code can be sped up. But Codon doesn't yet do this. That said, let's take a look at the total time spent by the program itself. And as you can see, it's about 10 times faster than our pure Python version. So while the overhead of starting the program is significant, the actual time to get a solution is a big improvement. And again, this is with a very poorly optimized and not very efficient algorithm. One other thing Codon can do, even in this early stage, is build standalone binaries from your programs, which has become something of a holy grail for a lot of Python users. So I have a shell script here to take care of that, and I run that now and generate a binary, which, as you can see, results in an image that's about 100K in size. And if I run that binary, I get results that are in line performance-wise with what we had before. And we don't have that pause at startup because everything has been compiled into a single binary ahead of time. Now let's take a look at one of Codon's limitations. Python gives us the freedom to create integers that are as large as we need them to be at the cost of performance. Codon's maximum default size for an integer is 64-bit, signed or unsigned. And this creates problems if we try to convert Python programs that depend on arbitrarily large integers. So I have here a second prime number search program, one that uses a different algorithm and one that requires large integers. So with a small prime number like 97, I can run that in Python. I can get an answer back in a fraction of a second. The numbers that you see here in the console, by the way, are from part of the program's internal calculations, and I'm printing them to the console for a reason I'll explain in a moment. Because under Codon, if I try to run the same code, I get a wrong answer. And as you can see from the internal output, it's because the numbers that are being used to determine the result are overflowing. We were using a signed 64-bit integer internally, and it's not big enough to hold the computations that we need. Now, according to Codon's documentation, I can manually create integers up to 2048 bits in size. For the sake of this demo, I'm going to show a version of this program that uses type annotations for Codon to use a 128-bit integer. And we can run that and get valid results, but that comes at a couple of other costs. First off, we can't use a range object for this loop. We have to do the loop manually because right now Codon doesn't support generating range objects for big integers. So that's one of the limitations that we have with Codon. Some of the other features that we take for granted in Python aren't available, and there's no guarantee that they'll be included as we expect them because Codon is still in such an early stage of development. So with all that in mind, here comes the big question. Is Python as a whole headed in this direction? Are we going to see the standard version of Python become more like this, where it compiles your program to machine-native code? The short answer, at least right now, is not really, and here's why. See, the big thing people care most about with Python is the world of Python software that's already out there. All the libraries and existing applications that work with Python don't really mean much if you can't use them with Python. That means any changes that get added to the reference version of Python need to be as backwards compatible as possible. In Python 3.11, the developers added some features that sped up the interpreter by as much as 60% in some cases. But they also sweated blood to make sure those changes worked universally. If they came at the expense of making older Python programs break, they wouldn't be very useful. So a lot of Codon's big speedups come at the expense of breaking compatibility with much of the existing ecosystem of Python apps and libraries. Now, that's fine if you're starting completely from scratch or if you're only using Codon for some specific component of an application instead of the whole thing. But the Codon approach, where we're basically rewriting the whole language from the ground up to be compiled to machine code, is probably not going to work for Python generally. So does that mean Codon is a dead end? No, not at all. One of the paths the developers are exploring with Codon is to allow it to integrate incrementally into existing Python programs. I mentioned before how you could use Codon to speed up some specific Python function that needs it, and you can leave the rest alone. But there's already technologies that do this for Python, like Numba and Cython, which I've covered in previous videos. So the big question that now comes to mind is, will Codon make it more convenient to do that than existing solutions? And that's a really valid question because some of these, like especially Cython, can be a little cumbersome to work with. This is a question I do want to explore later as Codon develops further. But that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.